Greetings to one and all. I'm Shanvi Manglodkar and I'm one of 32 change makers as a part of the FAIR project. I'd like to extend my gratitude to FAIR project for giving me this opportunity to meet such talented individuals and to understand the various viewpoints and ideas that they hold about topics that are of extreme importance and require our immediate attention on in today's day and age. Before I begin, I'd like to start with a quote by Max Carver. Max Carver said, "Empathy is the starting point for creating a community and taking action. It is the impetus for creating change." Unquote. Before I start, I'd like you all to think about what the term community means to you. Community, positive psychology, and the role that community psychologists play is the topic that I want to discuss with all of you today. So like I started with, community. Community as a term has extremely subjective interpretations depending upon our lived experiences and the ideas that we hold regarding these various terms. So when I say community, community by the literal definition means something that brings together individuals who come with collective ideas, beliefs, and similarities to live together and feel like a sense of belonging to a particular place or a particular topic that they believe in. Now, the role that positive psychology and community psychologists have is extremely important for us to understand in this regard. But before that, I'd like to bring your attention to another term, and that being crisis. When we think about crisis, we think about everything in a negative way. It has a very negative connotation attached to it for various obvious reasons. There's large-scale destruction, deaths, large-scale transformations that take place when we think about the term crisis. But if we try viewing it in another light, we can see that crisis actually has a number of positive ways in which it can be seen as well. And what I mean when I say this is that when we go through a crisis situation is when we understand that there is a change that needs to be made in a positive way. And that is exactly what community psychologists and positive psychology does. Positive psychology believes on the ideals of growth, happiness, and well-being of every individual. And that's exactly what community psychologists also believe in. But community psychologists focus on two very, very important aspects, being social change and social justice. And that is what I will be focusing on in my discussion today. Community psychologists help us understand how our environment plays a very important role in providing us with various solutions and interventions that can actually give us the space to grow and give every individual the opportunity that they require to grow in a manner that provides for a positive mental well-being of the person. And these various practices and interventions that are used by community psychologists is what I would like to discuss now. So community psychologists believe in carrying out a number of interventions and practices that they feel are required for every individual to feel a part of the community in which they live. The first being social intervention that takes place at the level of NGOs, wherein community psychologists work with NGOs to make sure that every individual's voice is heard and every individual is provided for in a manner that is equitable. And they do this by social distribution in a manner that is equal and for every individual to get the resources that they require. The second being organizational interventions. We know that organizations play a very important part on our mental health and well-being. So that's what community psychologists do. They work with organizations in building coalitions that provide for transformative changes. The third being getting people whose voices are often not heard and those who are directly impacted by social change and damage to get along with larger communities for very long-term and positive transformations to take place. The various other competencies that are associated with community psychologists include empowering marginalized communities. building agendas and policies along with local leaders, taking into the whole account of the person who is going through trauma, who is going through a crisis situation, in a manner that helps them come out of the situation in a positive way, that not only impacts their positive well-being emotionally but also physically. They build ideas, they build, implement policies that help the local communities, and that is what I want to focus on now. We have to understand that India has a number of local communities, as we know, and we need to take these people into focus, take their ideas, hold them as our partners and not just beneficiaries. We need to understand that they actually know and have devised various methods to help our climate. They help in increasing the food and nutrition aspect, which is extremely important for us, in a manner that also helps the climate and does not destroy it in any way. And that is why we need to use and take our farmers and their ideas and their viewpoints into consideration and treat them as our partners in every policy making and every agenda that we go ahead with. And that's what community psychologists also work to do. They try to understand each and every individual. They try to understand the issues faced by the person and help them grow and come out of it so that they feel like a sense of belongingness and identity associated with the place that they are in at a given point of time. Now, I would like to bring your attention to certain statistics that are alarming and very sad, but we need to understand these to actually move forward and use community psychologists and positive psychology in this regard. We know that half of our population has no access to clean drinking water, basic sanitation, healthcare. The economy is so unequally distributed that the 1% of the rich people have more wealth than the 99% of the people combined. And that is extremely sad if we see. And why I'm bringing focus onto these statistics is because we need to understand that if we use community psychologists and we use the various practices and interventions that they have devised, we can actually in small ways move ahead and create a very positive change, because that's exactly what they believe in. They believe in social justice and social change. How they do this is, again, few points that I would like to talk about are, first, goals. They make sure that people come together towards a particular goal that will benefit the community at large. They bring people together with similar ideas, similar viewpoints, similar futuristic views that they hold for themselves and for each other. The second being fairness. They make each individual in a community feel like their viewpoint is heard, that they are given all of the resources and all of the ideas that they need at a given point of time to move ahead with. Sensitivity, and this is extremely important. Like I began my discussion today with the topic of empathy. Empathy is extremely important for us to understand. I know that empathy has a number of different interpretations, but we need to view empathy in a positive way. We need to understand and look at various perspectives of individuals from their own, going into their shoes and seeing how they view a particular situation. Sympathy is very different from empathy, and I want to emphasize on this point. Sympathy is simply feeling bad for a person, but empathy is trying to understand where that person is coming from to the best of our capabilities. We will never be truly able to understand another individual because we have not lived that person's life, but all we can do is try our best to understand what they are going through in a given situation and move ahead, working along with them to help them and to help ourselves as well. And that is why community psychologists also focus on sensitivity to each other. They focus on how important it is to bring individuals together to overcome the whole crisis of climate change that we are facing today at a very alarming rate. And we need to understand these various interventions and practices. The sad truth is that in our country today, community psychologists aren't given much importance. And that is the very reason that I wanted to talk about it as well. if we are able to understand the positive impacts that these individuals can have in our lives, it can benefit us to a great, great deal. Now again, I'd like to end by talking about the importance of positive psychology in community psychologists. Community psychologists help each and every individual who is going through a crisis situation to understand the situation better, to adapt to it in a better light, to understand that they need to work with each other to sort of get out of that situation and come out of it in a manner that does not impact their mental health and well-being in a negative way. They devise sustainable changes. They focus on challenging structural changes in the system which are not positive, which are not equitable. And they help individuals understand these changes and help them grow out of it in a positive light. They devise sustainable changes to provide for and impact social change in a positive direction. And most importantly, they work with marginalized people to understand all of the situations that they are going through and help them come out of those situations in a positive way. So that is what I wanted to talk about, because I feel like once we're able to implement positive psychology aspects and we're able to implement the strategies and the various interventions that community psychologists are actually rigorously working on every day, we can move towards a society that is not only mentally healthy, not only mentally providing for their well-being, but is also giving each individual the feeling that he or she belongs to a particular society, that they have a common identity. And therefore, community psychology needs to be given the importance and the focus on in our country today, because it will help us move ahead in a very positive direction. Social change, social justice, these two are extremely important terms that we have to keep focusing on. And community psychologists use these two terms along with positive psychology aspects to help our community thrive, to grow, to protect their health, to protect their mental well-being, and to help each other feel like they're a part of society. Thank you very much, and I'd like you all to understand that we need to protect our health, we need to protect our mental well-being each and every day, because that is the only way we will be able to move ahead and go in a positive direction towards whatever goals that we need to reach. So we need to help each other, but first we need to help ourselves. And community psychologists and positive psychology needs to be given the attention that it requires and it deserves to have today. Thank you all.